Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To start this video, just a reminder that tomorrow SpaceX will be launching their second mission of 2022. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Transporter 3 mission is expected to lift off tomorrow, Thursday 13th at 3:25pm UTC or 10:25am Eastern Time. Space News posted an article about Starlink. It says SpaceX has dropped a plan to use Falcon 9 to launch the 30,000 satellites in its proposed second generation Starlink broadband constellation and is instead focusing on a configuration leveraging its upcoming Starship vehicle. The decision follows development progress that SpaceX said exceeded the company's expectations and means it could start launching the Gen 2 system as early as March 2022, SpaceX lawyer William Wiltshire said in a January 7th letter to the Federal Communications Commission. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the work continuing on the orbital launch mount. The mount was seen doing some venting as they get closer to being ready for the first orbital launch. Engineers continue to work on the chopstick catching arms with this beam installed. The chopstick catching arms were also raised all the way to the top of the tower. Elon Musk posted a cool video on Twitter of the Starship launch and catch tower. These ballast bags were also added at some point for some load testing. Work on the Starship quick disconnect arm has also been continuing. With the testing of the catching arm, SpaceX also tested the Starship QD arm. This transport mount was moved to the launch site with a Starship QD connector. The berm at the launch site continues to be removed. Crews continue to work on the Starship 20 prototype, hopefully for more testing soon. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures once again, we did have a closure scheduled for some testing today, but that was cancelled. However, there are backup road closures of tomorrow, Thursday 13th and Friday 14th. The Starship 24 common dome section was recently sleeved in the yard. On the right is the B2.1 test tank, which is still sitting at the propellant production site. The bottom part of the Booster 3 prototype has continued to be scrapped. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.